Well, we're back.
Oh, well, surprisingly, hope you guys missed us. Took all six of you.
All six, seven, sir. Hopefully.
Hopefully, maybe. Maybe, maybe.
Seven.
But yeah, there's a lot. A lot to talk about.
All right, so.
Because we missed 3 weeks.
All right, let's just go in order here, and I want to talk about the NFL honors first.
Okay.
No, we'll save it for a little later. What happened that day? Because now that we have a time to calm down from our Patriots fandom here,
when?
I'm gonna wear my 2016 commemorative T-shirt. All right. Let's talk about the NFL honors.
Yes.
Who actually won these damn things? So in other words, like this is their, of course, their big award show. I also want to talk about the NFL Hall of Fame. Who was accepted in the Hall of Fame? Who was not. So let's start with the MVP, who was given to Matt Ryan.
Yep.
Which, you know, well deserved.
Yeah, he led up the league. No much more to say than that. I mean, he had a great season.
Yep, led the league in, I think, pass rating and second in touchdowns and third in yards.
Yeah.
So understandable. Coach of the Year, Jason Garrett. I would have given it to Bill, but they don't like Bill as a whole.
I don't know. I wouldn't have given it to Jason Garrett. Yeah. Just me, but, you know.
I would also give an Adam Gase, too, for getting that team back to respectable 10-6 record. Assistant Coach of the Year, Kyle Shanahan, who is now the head coach of San Francisco.
Wonderful.
Offensive Player of the Year, Matt Ryan. Really should have been Zeke.
Yeah.
This should have been Zeke. AP Defensive Player of the Year, Khalil, a.k.a. as Jay Wall likes to call it, the award that someone else will get because J.J. Watt didn't play this year.
Yeah.
Went to Khalil Mack. You're the Raiders guy. You can tell me, is it well-deserved?
Yeah. Khalil Mack. Khalil Mack's a stud. I have no other words to describe that.
Pepsi Next Rookie of the Year belongs to Dak Prescott.
And also AP Offensive Rookie of the Year also went to Dak Prescott.
Hi. This prediction got to Zeke. I'm sorry, but Zeke's the better player.
He meant more to the team.
Yeah. Defensive Player of the Year, Joey Bosa. 10.5 sacks in 14 games. I gotta give him that.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a beast. AP Comeback Player of the Year, Jordy Nelson.
There's really no other, really.
Yep.
Who were they? That shouldn't have gone to anyone else but him.
Fantasy Player of the Year, David Johnson.
Unbelievable.
Don Shula, High School Coach of the Year, it don't matter if it's just a high school stuff. Walter Payton Man of the Year, Eli Manning, and Larry Fitzgerald. First ever tie.
I know, yes, I said, them really had a tie for the Man of the Year award.
FedEx Player of the Year, Matt Ryan. FedEx Ground Player of the Year, Zeke Elliott.
Air went to Matt Ryan, ground went to Zeke.
Bridgewater Play Performance belonged to Jameis Winston and Mike Evans. I posted him as like that big touchdown pass.
Yeah.
I forgot what it is. Greatest on the Road, Le'Veon Bell. Le'Veon Bell was awesome this season.
Yeah.
Besides the ace of time.
Definitely, yeah.
Still to service, you know, Dan Quinn, really good with the Army. Deacon Jones Award, so best pass rusher. That would defeat. That would be easily. Clutch performer, Derek Carr. Best offensive line in football, Dallas Cowboys.
That's obvious.
And Art Rooney Award went to Frank Gore. I think that's for charity work mainly.
Yeah.
Okay, so here are your 2017 Hall of Famers. LT, deserving.
Yeah.
Should have been first ballot.
I think it was too, right?
Yeah, this was his first year. Yeah. So I'm saying he's first ballot Hall of Famer. Warren Anderson, leading scorer in the NFL. Yeah.
Played forever. Played until he was like almost 50 years old.
Jason Taylor.
Yeah, definitely, yes.
Kenny Easley, the offensive tackle, fine.
No, the strong safety for the Seahawks.
Oh, okay. Next up is Jerry Jones.
Tell him why he got in this year.
Yeah, they had to put one executive in, Terrell Davis.
Terrell Davis and Kurt Warner.
I don't think Terrell Davis should have got in, but that's up.
Definitely not. This isn't first ballot for him, is it? Is it not, or is it?
No, I think it's his third time trying.
I mean, he had a couple of 2,000-yard seasons, and like he was kind of the backbone of that team in a way.
But he was only good for like 5 years. That's the thing. He was only good for 5 years. But the biggest crime of this whole thing, and you know where I'm going with this, T.O. should have got in. The only reason why he didn't get in is because he's addicted.
Yeah.
T.O., second all-time in receptions, second all-time in yards, third in touchdowns. Sure, he didn't win a Super Bowl, and he has, like, the most drops ever, but Brett Favre got in first ballot. He threw the most interceptions. That's because he's good to the media.
I would have replaced TD with TO, to be honest.
Yeah.
Because I think Owens definitely, he'll get it next year without a shadow of a doubt.
That's why I said last year.
And he should have gotten it regardless. I mean, he should be in already.
He was
some people you look at it and like he should be in, like Ty Law should be in the Hall of Fame. He's one of the best corners in league history.
Yep. I think he should. I think
it's a shame that he's not in the Hall of Fame.
He'll get
Lauri Molloy too. Same thing. He's not a shame. He's not in the Hall of Fame.
Here's the thing. I don't think T.O.'s gonna get him because there's another big time wide receiver who's up next year. Named Randy Moss.
Moss is getting in first ballot.
Yep, he should. It says 19 NFL. I just want to look up who's up. All right, I just want to take a look who's up for Hall of Fame ballots. Six candidates for the Hall of Fame class in 2018. So there's some big names. Ray Lewis, Randy Moss, Brian Urlacher, Rondé Barber, Brian Dawkins, and Richard Seymour.
Yeah, I don't think Seymour's going to get in.
No, it should be. It really should be T.O. T.O. should get in.
T.O., not Seymour, but T.O. definitely, yeah.
T.O. should. You know who I also think should get in? Mari Schottenheimer. I don't think he's in the Hall of Fame yet. I don't think he is. And then, he didn't play well in the playoffs, but he's fourth in all-time wins.
He's got to get in there.
He's count for something. All right, so now let's get to the game. The Patriots defeated the Atlanta Falcons 34-28 in the greatest comeback in playoff history.
Super Bowl history.
Well, yeah, definitely Super Bowl history.
Super Bowl history.
But I think it's not the largest comeback. The largest comeback was 32 points. I think it was by the Bills and the Oilers. I think that's what it was. But anyway, let's get to this whole thing.
I think it's the largest comeback in Super Bowl's history. I think it is.
No, it is. It's by a landslide, 25 points. It only ever came back from 10 points or more. So let's just get this thing started here. So the score was in the first half. Yeah. I thought the game was pretty sloppy.
Yeah, first quarter looked pretty freaking sloppy, but you know.
Yep. I think I said in the preview that the key of the game is turnovers. Who's going to turn over the ball over first? LeGarrette Blount fumbled on 40.
Blount fumbled it. Brady, they gave him 14 points.
Yep.
They spotted him 14 points. Atlanta Falcons jumped onto a massive 21-0 lead.
Yep, zero is going to count out. Devonta Freeman went in untouched, 5 yards out. Matt Ryan made a beautiful pass to Austin Hooper.
Yeah, in the back of the end zone. Yep. Nice.
And then the pick off by Robert Alford, the pick 6 by
82 yards.
Yep.
That kind of had me down.
Yep.
You know, just, it's, you know, that pick was like, no one's in sight.
Yeah.
No, Brady made an attempt.
He made a bad
at a tackle.
He made a bad throw. And interesting. Yeah. I didn't realize this. I didn't give Atlanta credit for this. They're fast.
Yeah.
They play better.
When Alford made that jump on Brady and, like, he was, when he was at, like, the 30-yard line or 20-yard line, no one was near him.
Yep.
No one. He was by himself. He was walking past the 10-yard line because no one was even near him.
Yep. It seemed as though nothing was going for the Patriots. In particular, this call, I remember this, it sticks in my brain here. The more that I've watched this game several times.
Yeah.
Honestly, the past 3 weeks. So, the Patriots driving down, taking a lot of time. James White goes to the one. It looks like they're gonna, get a score here, like a touchdown. So before the half ends, and maybe it looks like it's manageable.
Yeah,
14 points down, and it might have been almost pulled off at Beasley's jersey. Gets called back. Patriots get field goal, 21-3, going into halftime. First start of the half, kind of good. The Patriots get a 3-and-out. Then they proceed to do nothing in the next possession, and then Atlanta drives down the field. Two great catches by Julio Jones, and then Tevin Coleman goes in untouched on a pass by Matt Ryan, 28-3.
At this point, you know, I was starting to lose a little bit of the faith. I never lost it fully because, let's be honest here, Tom Brady is the most clutch quarterback of all time. He's come back from multiple deficits in his career.
Yep.
And
but this was...
This one seemed like it was daunting. And what he did was even more special.
Yep. Which, we'll get to this in a second, but I sat there in absolute awe. And I could have left.
Yeah.
I was tempted to leave. But
I sat there and I'm like, I'm going to watch this game to the end no matter what.
Here's the thing. I stay because I like the trophy hand-up celebration. You know, I think it's kind of cool. Even though it's the Falcons. I have nothing against the Atlanta Falcons. Yeah. I don't. And I still don't. So, let's keep on going here. So, the Patriots score a touchdown with 2 minutes left to go in the third quarter. James White gets a 5-yard touchdown pass by Tom Brady. Disgusting. Misses the extra point.
Yeah.
And that's when my aunt got up and said, F, I'm going to bed.
Yeah.
And then her brother went home. So it was me, my uncle, my cousin, and her boyfriend. All there, just sitting there like, all right, well, we're just going to be here watching until the very end. That's when he brought up the vodka shots. That's when those came.
Yeah. I mean, at my house, you know, my brother's friend Ryan never lost faith in the Patriots the entire time. He said, you know, we have a chance. You know, I'm not going to, you know, doubt this team. It's looking daunting, but we're still in it.
Once he missed the PAT,
that was it. He wanted Gaskowski traded instantly before he even got off the field.
Yep.
Before he got to the sidelines.
You have been traded to someone else. All right. So this is when it gets kind of, okay.
It's getting interesting.
Okay, so Gaskowski kicks on a 33-yard field goal after a big stop by Atlanta, 2 sacks by Garrett. Great Jarrett. 28 of 12. Then this is where things get stupid.
Yeah. Atlanta's driving up the field.
Yep.
And
Third and one,
and instead of just running the ball.
Or falling ass backwards for that matter.
They decide to throw.
That's how much that dropped.
And Hightower blows right past his man.
That was Devontae Freeman. He missed a block.
And he strip sacks Matt Ryan.
Yep.
And the
recovered by the
big,
Patriots.
Fat, massive man of humanity, Alan Branch, falls on it.
Yep.
Patriots go down.
And they score.
That would made the man pay for a turnover, which you should do in the game of football. You should make a pay for turning the ball over, which we did.
6 minutes left to go.
And two-point conversion was good.
Yep.
Which made 20-20.
Tom Brady throws to Danny Amendola. Two-point conversion, which was a nice, you know, fake where all went over his head. It actually fooled me. He's like, son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Nope. James White had it. He ran in. At this point, I'm like, okay, there's a shot here. There's a chance. Now, this is where it gets dumb.
Yeah.
So, Julio Jones makes an unbelievable catch. Matt Ryan throws a perfect pass, and Jones, and a lot of people say compared to the different Tyree than Mario Manningham and the Carl Lockett. Here's the difference between that. Those were all luck. This was pure skill.
Yeah.
This was.
This is more along the lines of the Manningham catch.
I was
on
at
the
sidelines. I was at the Manningham catch. Manningham was, that was really lucky. This one was just pure on Milton.
I'm saying it's like in that
yep.
realm of like a sideline catch.
Yep.
That gets him deep ball way downfield.
Yep. So here we go. We're setting up here. All they have to do is either hand the ball off 3 times because they're having a rush. And,
yeah.
And their kicker, Matt Bryant, has a massive leg. First play gets stuffed. Second and 10. Matt Ryan takes a 7-step drop. He gets sacked. By I think it was Trey Flowers.
Yeah, Flowers got in there, got
yep. And then they get a holding call.
Yeah, so they run the play.
Yep.
And that's like, okay, they just got back in a field goal range. And then they got the holding call.
Yep.
Called on them. And it's like, at that point in time, you know, I think they got maybe, what, like 2 or 3 yards on the next play?
They got like five. There's a throw to Gabriel and 5 yards left to play.
Oh, it was incomplete because it was... It was defended.
Yeah.
So, they end up punting.
Yep.
Patriots, I think we started, the 10-yard line or 5?
Yep.
So, it was really close to the end zone.
It was like the drive past that 98 and a half. It was like kind of like we started at 7-yard line, so it was like
yeah.
93-yard drive.
So, didn't really do anything the first two
passes.
And
then Brady hits Hogan.
Third pass, he hits, I think he hit Amendola for the first down.
Yep.
Or Amendola. Yeah, Amendola for the first down.
Which
hits Hogan on a comeback route. Or was that in the overtime?
No, that was overtime.
Yeah, so
he
hits Malcolm Mitchell and for a nice little for a first down.
Yep.
Mitchell puts the ball on the ground. Luckily, he had enough smarts to pick the ball back up again.
Yep.
Or else that's a fumble.
Yeah.
So they're driving down the field. Edelman makes a ridiculous catch. I don't even know.
That was pure luck. That was pure 100%.
100% luck.
Was it first down?
I think it was first down, yeah.
Because what happened? Because Brady throws it up. It was almost intercepted.
It was. I thought it was being picked off.
Robert Alford was at a second pick. He drops down, hits off someone's leg. Then Edelman gets it. He lets it go, and he grabs it again before it hits the ground.
That is insane. It is the it's one of the most magical plays like I've ever seen go in our favor for the first time. I was like, wow. We've had...
Why are they getting rolled? They got
we've
it.
Had one, we've had two...
Three.
Three plays go against us. Yep. That cost, not the one against the Seahawks with Tyler Lockett, but the other two cost us to win.
Yep.
And they've had three plays. We finally got our magical play.
Yep.
And it came at the right time.
Yep. So we keep driving down the field. James White scores a 1-yard touchdown. Brady throws Amendola 2 points, tie game. We go to overtime. For the first time in Super Bowl history, it's overtime. And then once the Patriots won the coin toss, I'm like, they've won this game.
Yeah.
I looked up and said, oh, they won this game.
And then it...
Almost suspect.
Yeah, there's a screen pass to James White. I think it was like second down.
Yep, almost suspect.
And almost got picked off.
Yep, and if he picked it off, it would have gone all the way the other way.
Their own 20, I think. Yep. And
almost a pick six.
It was almost an easy pick six.
Yep.
So the Patriots just pick apart Atlanta's defense, get down to the goal line. Throws a pass to Bennett and Devondre Campbell with the pass interference on the 1 yard line.
Now, a lot of people are complaining that you shouldn't do that, and my argument is this: you really shouldn't call a 25-point game in the third quarter. You should be handing the ball. Okay. Don't complain about the call when you're up by 25 points and you still blew the lead.
So now they Seahawks it on the first play after the pass interference call.
They throw a fade to Ben, which is almost picked up by Beasley.
They almost picked him off. Next play, second down, run it with James White. Game over. Patriots are your Super Bowl champions.
Super Bowl 51 champions.
For the fifth frickin' time.
Yep.
There is no denying it anymore. Tom Brady is the greatest quarterback of all time. There's no more denying it.
I would say he's now moved up into the top, the top five players. Of course, like, if you're asking me, like, who I put in the top five, one for me is Barry Sanders in terms of, like...
Sanders is probably my top.
Yeah, it's...
Number one. He was a winner on a team that had no offensive line.
And no offensive line. He was just great. So Barry Sanders could have played longer. He could have really gotten the rush title without an offensive line or a quarterback, so he knew it was going to hit. Lawrence Taylor. Changed the game.
Game changer on defense.
Jerry Rice.
Game changer on offense.
Tom Brady. Then probably Jim Brown.
Yeah.
But that's just me, like, spitball.
Jim Brown definitely deserves to be in the top five. Yep. Game changer also, too, for the Cleveland Browns. Won the multiple championships. Single-handedly.
Yep.
Not really broke the color barrier, but was discriminated a lot.
Oh, yes.
In his career.
He definitely had a lot of bad
he didn't really deserve it.
Yeah.
It was just a product of that time period.
It was the 60s.
It was the 50s and the 60s, and a lot of people just weren't really respected enough around this time.
So,
but yeah.
So the big question, is it a Patriots comeback or an Atlanta choke?
50-50.
I say it's... Well, what is it more?
I'd say more of a Atlanta choke.
Yeah, it's a 25-point lead about 6 minutes left to
go. It's 50-50 to me because it's the greatest comeback in the history of the Super Bowl.
Yep.
And also, too, it's the biggest choke in the history of the Super Bowl.
Yep.
So...
That's the largest... So now Brady has... Brady now is 5. Okay, so the trophy celebration happens. He's named MVP. Now, me personally, I wouldn't have given Brady the MVP. The MVP for me for that game was James White.
He broke the record for catches.
Yep. Well, most catches and most points.
Yeah. and a lot of that game, too, was like when they throw it, like in the first half, they throw it to Lewis, they throw it to White. It's like one little tap and they go down the turf. But in the second half of that game, they were taking passes and they were running the distance. It wasn't like that. No one could stop them. It's like, I remember like one play, like White Bailey got like, the guy got like two fingers on him.
Yep.
And he like, and he went down. I'm like, are you kidding me? Like, that's how this is going to go? But then the second half, he started catching the screen pass. He's going 20, 30 yards downfield. And I'm like, it's just more, it's more so just, Dylan's defense is worn down.
Okay. All right. So we're going to, now let's move on to the final, I guess the final segment of the show.
14 receptions for 110 yards.
So, the final segment of this show, where we preview all the teams, got to say their biggest offseason need, and we're going to make a bull rush, like quick prediction of what they'll end up last next season.
Yeah.
So, Arizona Cardinals. Also, season MLS. Okay, so this is the grade season, what they need. Are they going to be next season? Headline.
Yep.
I think that's right. Okay. So, Arizona Cardinals.
What they, we'll start with what they need, because that's...
Yeah.
Oh, more play. So, what they need.
I think offensive line.
They need another corner.
Besides, yeah, besides Peterson.
Corner. Re-sign Calais Campbell. Get another lineman.
Yeah, I'd say offensive lineman is their biggest need. And also a quarterback.
Quarterback, yeah.
Getting a quarterback.
They need, you need to invest in that. I think the draft won this year.
Yep. All right. So, great. D. Yeah.
There's no denying that they underachieved.
Yep.
They needed a play. They didn't have the horses to go. Their defense was very bad.
No, actually, their defense was
top. A pass defense.
No, they're
Patrick Peterson was getting roasted all season long.
If their defense was the problem, it was Carson Palmer. Carson Palmer made a major step backwards. And
oh, he was one of the main reasons.
I think he was the main reason. And also, Bruce Arians doesn't want to adapt. So, season headline, I said super disappointment. It's pretty easy.
They're supposed to be like a Super Bowl contender.
They were my pick for the Super Bowl to be in there. All right, Atlanta Falcons. Biggest need.
Corner.
I would say corner. Besides the Alfonso Gettard, I would also say how about a guy that has a clue.
He's an offensive coordinator.
Yeah.
Steve Sarkisian, basically.
Hand the ball off. Someone who knows that you're supposed to hand the ball off on 3rd and 1. Oh, God. Run the ball. That's all you gotta do is run the ball.
Didn't do it.
Nope. All right. Grade A. This is definitely an A.
Made to the Super Bowl.
Yeah. We said we're going to... Because me and you thought they're going to go 8-8.
Yeah.
At best. And then they're going to collapse. They made the Super Bowl. So, good for them. So, this is in the headline... I say it's a Matty Ice melt.
Yeah. Matty Ice melt or just choke.
Yep. Choking hazards. Baltimore Ravens. Biggest need is running back.
Yes. They're running back.
And receiver.
Offensive line. They need a couple linemen because one of them's going to leave.
Yep. And a receiver to replace Steve Smith.
Yep.
So I guess I have another old one. So is Andre Johnson available? How about Chad drafting? We pull him out for time. Why not? Ted. Headline, stuck in mud.
Yeah.
All right. Bills.
On paper, I said this before we went on camera. On paper.
Yep.
When you look at this Bills team, you look at them. It's a playoff team.
Yep.
On paper. But there's glaring needs.
Head coaching, quarterback.
Quarterback,
second
lineman.
Receiver.
They need wide receivers, period.
Yeah.
Corners.
Yeah, because I don't think Stephon Gilmore's going to stay there.
Safeties. Like, they have a need at every position, pretty much. Besides like linebacker and defensive line.
Yep, and running back.
Oh, yeah.
And McCoy.
They could lose Gillisley.
Yep.
I think Gillisley will take. I think Gillisley could be a starting running back in the NFL. All
right,
he's proved it.
So grade C.
Yeah,
C minus.
Middle of the pack.
Yeah. I'd say probably. I'm gonna give it for the Ravens. Ravens C.
Yeah,
they're just okay. All right, so headline for the Bills. Rex was here. Rex was Carolina.
Stuck in mud.
Stuck in mud. Yeah, that's...
that's the Buffalo Bills for you.
Stampede. Shit. Alright, Carolina Panthers. Corner?
Oh, definitely corner. Yes. That's not even a fucking like...
29th against the pass. Terrible. I think they need a running back, too. I think Jonathan Stewart's getting too old.
Yeah.
And how about a new head coach? That'd be great.
Lineman, too?
Yep. Grade F.
F, yeah. I got a great headline. Super Bowl hangover.
All right. I would have... I'm trying to think of a pun with Norman. I can't think of one. Normality?
Yeah.
There you go. Normality. Back to normal. Bears.
Quarterback.
Quarterback is easy.
Wide receiver. Corner. Safety.
Defensive line. Head coach.
Defensive line, head coach.
They don't need an offensive line or a running back. That's fine. So yeah. They're fine there. So basically, most everything. So headline. Pussies at the Midway.
Yeah.
They're not the monsters at the Midway, they're just the pussies at the Midway. Cutler. Cutler! Season gray.
I wouldn't even have I just had a picture of Jay Cutler. I don't even have a headline.
Just Jay Cutler's, you know.
Just Jay Cutler throwing a pick.
So that's it. It's all the game highlights. And the head and grade, probably F.
Yeah, F, definitely.
Bengals. They need to replenish their defense. I think they need a second receiver.
Oh, they let two of their receivers go like idiots.
Yep. And a new head coach again. But yep. They've retained him.
They need a new head coach. Enough. Yeah. Enough is enough. Yeah. Marvin Lewis, the king of not knowing what to do.
And this is the headline. I'm still sticking with my one, Thug Life.
Yeah.
Doesn't choose you.
Thug Life, yeah.
Actually, no, sorry, Dad. I got a better one. It's one of my old sayings. You can't shine a sneaker.
Yep.
No
matter what you do, you can't polish a turd.
Yeah, or it's like, you put makeup on a pig, it's still a pig.
Yeah, exactly. You know, that's still the same old Bengals. You know, they're not adapting. They're still trying to beat the shit out of everyone.
Browns.
Everything?
Everything, yeah. That's pretty much true.
Everything?
Everything, again. They're having another rebuilding season for the 18th straight year. They're nearly 20 years into their existence. And they're still
again.
Rebuilding.
Chris, they're lucky to be rewarded the franchise for the second time.
They have only made the playoffs once in 20 years.
And you know what happened in that game? They threw bottles. All
was that
over
one,
the place.
Was that the bottle gate?
That was
the
bottle gate.
Yeah, son of a bitch. Alright. Season headline, mistake by the lake. Multiple.
No end in sight.
grade, W. Withdrawn.
Incomplete. It's like I used to get those like I's in your test and you didn't finish them, you just wanted to pass it in because you had to go to your next class.
Yep.
That's what they get. Because they weren't finished with the offseason.
Okay. Dallas Cowboys. Defensive line?
Line, yeah. Corner?
Sheldon Richardson, so I heard that they're interested in it.
Line and corner.
Yep.
Not offensive line. Offensive line's good for the next 50 million years for that team. Definitely defensive line.
Linebackers. Defense, actually.
A defense? Yeah. Because Terrence Williams is probably gone.
Yep.
He's probably going to take the money and run. So, another receiver, too.
Yep. Alright, so... Grade, I'm going to give it an A.
Yeah, hey, I mean...
Biggest improvement.
Biggest improvement, they overachieved.
Yep.
And choked in the biggest game.
Hey, that's the Dallas Cowboys.
Choked in the biggest game.
Alright. So, season headline.
Dallas car crash.
Feed the beast.
Yep.
Denver Broncos.
Quarterback.
I wouldn't say quarterback. I'd say the tackle. Offensive tackle.
Yeah, both of them.
Yep.
They're both terrible.
I would say probably signing Tony Romo. Romo's a no-no.
Romo's defense.
Damn it, I should have used that one. Should use that one for Dallas. Tony's a no-go. Tony's a no-go. I'm Jim Rome.
Tony's a no-go. I'm Jim Rome.
Yep. Dallas. I'm sorry, not Dallas. Denver. Yeah, so probably quarterback too, but I'm going to give, because they want to develop Paxton Lynch, so it's fine, but.
And Paxton Lynch is awful.
He plays
so.
There's still one, you know what the sad part is? Still not the worst one in this draft. We'll get to him later.
Yeah.
So, headline, Orange crushed.
And yeah.
Grade is a C. Started out well and it fell apart.
See, yeah, definitely.
Detroit Lions. I can't give them an A because they actually made the playoffs. But I would, actually, I'll give them a B.
I give them a B.
B because it was just Matt Stafford and no one else.
Yeah.
A
pass rusher opposite of Ziggy Ansah.
Yep.
And maybe another corner.
Oh, then Darius Slay. How about a receiver that can catch the ball?
I mean, they've invested a lot of money over the past couple of seasons on receivers, including Calvin, too, but...
Calvin's not there anymore, so...
Calvin's not there anymore. They don't really need line now.
No. Surprisingly, no. That's
running back?
Yes, running back, too. Their running backs were terrible.
Yeah, they got a Justin Forsett.
Yeah, Theo Riddick got hurt, which would screw him over. All right. Headline...
Speared.
Face mask. Green Bay Packers. Your brother's free.
Defense.
Yeah, that's pretty good. How about a new coordinator? Two.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there we go.
New coordinator.
A running back that's not timeline, that's not a converted wide receiver into a running
back.
Yep,
running back.
Because I don't think they're going to keep any lazy.
Wide out. Defense.
Defense. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff for you. Alright, so great for the season. They had a terrible order.
C.
But a great finish. B.
You got a C.
Even a B, because they actually did make it to the NFC title game. Headline.
Porked. Roasted.
I shouldn't say that.
Toasted.
Oh god, I shouldn't say that. Fuck. Fuck it, I'm gonna say Aroid. Next. Okay, fine. I'll actually give a good one. Ran out of gas.
Yeah.
Texans. Quarterback.
Again. Quarterback. Line's not too bad.
Their line. No, their offense was terrible. Defensively, they're fine.
Defensive. I have a couple of. Well, a couple of players are hurt.
Yeah.
But this still needs to move on the line. Corner safeties, linebackers, ends fine, tackles are fine.
Yep.
They really don't have any glaring needs besides the quarterback.
Except for the quarterback. Season. C. This is episode C.
C.
And
for crappy.
Yeah. Headline, Houston.
Houston, Brock Osweiler. Is my headline.
Colts.
Gregson
got fired.
Gregson was a major. Wide receiver.
Yeah, another receiver.
Offensive line help.
Defensive
line help. Quarterback help. Safety help. Linebacker help.
Yep. You know, all the
team
things.
Help.
Okay. Grade F. This is F team. And Susan headline.
Lost at sea.
Lost at sea. I would just say...
Shipwrecked.
Unlucky.
Unlucky. Yeah. Shipwrecked. Lost at sea.
It's a white mountain up in the... Jacksonville Jaguars. This is probably one of the bigger disappointments.
I don't... You know, with the addition of Doug Moon as the head coach and Tom Coughlin as the executive... of football operations, I don't think they have any glaring needs. Their glaring needs were the coach.
Yep.
And they played pretty well under Doug Marone.
I can say center, just to pick a position.
Center, yeah. Need a little bit of help on the line, but other than that, they can resign Prince Mukamura.
Maybe a running back.
Yeah.
That's not.
Yeah, they do need a good back.
Yep.
There's some names out there in the draft, and some names out there in free agency that they can pick up.
Leonard Fournette. This is the team I think.
Fournette, Dalvin Cook, and yep. So there's still a couple of good backs who win a free agency.
All right, so grade in the headline. I was at an F. And I did not want to call them when I want to call them because that's derogatory towards homosexuals. Don't want to call them.
I'll give it a D. I saw some improvement in the final three games that I didn't see at all in the first however 15 games or 14 games of the season.
Here's what I'll say, ready? Regression.
Definitely regression. Had they fired Gus Bradley earlier, they probably could have saved their season. As in the beginning of the season.
I've been calling for it since day one. Chiefs.
There's really no glaring needs though.
Quarterback.
Besides Alex Smith, Alex Smith obviously is a glaring hole on our offense when he has 15 touchdowns and is a starting quarterback.
By the way, Travis Kelce, you tool.
Ready? Travis Kelce, dickhead.
When your offensive lineman takes a defensive lineman that's smaller than him and puts him to the ground, he helped.
It's a holding call.
Yep.
It's simple. It's simple football rules.
Yep. And you didn't know that. So that's the biggest need. It's also a wide receiver as well, I think.
Yep. It's Tyreek Hill, but still.
Yep. All right. So grade and headline. So I'd be...
C? Because...
I'll say B. Because they did win the division.
They did win the division, but they no-showed in the playoffs.
Yep.
Great job, Alex.
All right, here we go. Headline, holding out.
Holding out or clock management?
I was like, holding out for time. There, we combined the two of them. Holding out for time. We have a tool and a white beater on the team. Tyreek Hill and Travis Kelce. L.A.
Everything.
F.
F, everything. Disaster. Is my headline.
It was an un... Alright.
We don't even need to go over that team.
I just want to make sure here. Did they also... Yes, they did. And guess what? The two wins that San Francisco has...
One of them was them. They blew them out on opening night.
No, both of them were them.
They lost both times to the 49ers. Wow. Are you fucking kidding me? 1-point loss in the first game of the season, they got blown out.
Alright.
Everything F.
Niners bitch.
Yes.
Miami.
Miami. Offensive line help because there's traded Brandon Albert.
Yep. Oh, they also received Julius Thomas.
Julius Thomas, yeah.
Cornerback.
Corner help to go along with Vontae Davis when he's on the field.
Yep.
No, Vontae Davis is not Colts. No, I know.
That would be Brian Maxwell.
Maxwell. If he can stay on the field because he was not healthy last year either. What are those? Line help.
Corner help.
Running
back,
maybe?
No, JJ I think improved.
Ajayi, yeah.
So, all right, great headline. I'm going to give this one a B and gaze into the future.
Yeah. I gave it a B, and I'd say, it's a good season.
Yeah.
But, you know.
If you can improve upon.
My other would be improvement.
Improvement, yeah.
Because they did improve. They made the playoffs. I mean, they had one hell of a run there.
Yep. Minnesota Vikings.
Offensive line.
Oh, my God. Their offensive line. Putrid. Running back.
Running back, wide receiver.
Yeah, receiver too.
Receiver, back, because Peterson's most likely gone.
Yep.
That's it, really. And then.
Yep.
F.
This is the headline. I'm going to give it a D. And headline, we won September.
I agree with you on that. Yeah. They did win September. They won 6 games in September.
Yeah, but where did they finish? 8-8.
Yeah.
They went 2-8 the rest of the way. New England Patriots. Linebacker. Tight end.
Linebacker, tight end, running back.
I wouldn't say running back. I think they're set at
running back. Help. No, they don't have a running back.
I guess the biggest question is, are they going to trade him?
I heard imminent and I heard no.
You've heard both.
I've heard both.
That's the problem.
You guys aren't here for Professor Blanchett's class, are you?
No.
There's no class in here. Yeah. Is there?
No, there's no. I already saw earlier. Randomly switched in.
Yep.
Would have done that a long time ago.
Plus, people would be showing up by now.
Yeah.
All right. So, grade A, obviously, because they won the Super Bowl.
Yep.
And that is the. Actually, no. Headline GOAT.
Yep. Champs.
Yep. Saints. Need a defense.
Need a defense.
Badly. Terrible.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty much. I think that covers it.
And?
All right. So, grade, I'm going to give it a C because the offense played well.
Yeah.
And the defense played better down the stretch. Still was terrible, but still they played better than they did. As for a headline, a system failure.
Yep.
New York Jets. Quarterback.
Corner.
Quarter
and cornerback. Line help.
Offensive and defensive. They got blowed up.
Safety.
Headline, just end their season. Giants.
Disaster. Train wreck.
Train wreck. Fits the bet.
Fits to the bank.
Yep. Giants.
There's really no glaring needs for that team.
I'd say running back because there's... Cut.
They caught him, yeah. They covered Chuck Jennings, so yeah.
Well, other than that, their defense is really good.
You have a good defense.
Yep. So, I'd also draft a quarterback for the future. If there is one draft that you want to draft.
Eli's not getting any younger.
No.
That and a running back.
Headline, shipwrecked.
Shipwrecked, yep. Party hard.
Yeah, party hard.
Party like a rock star. You can rip off that Andrew. CKWK.
OBJTOOL. You missed your snap onto him. He might have taken over the number one spot.
Yep.
He might have. I don't know. He has some good attempts. Travis Kelce and Jay Cutler are obviously some good ones. Oakland Raiders.
Defense. Defensive corner help.
Yep.
Corner and safety help.
Everything else on offense is fine. As for the, they did quit at the end, I will say that much. That does concern me a little bit. They kind of quit.
They did.
After Derek Carr went down.
Yeah. They didn't even bother.
Yep. So great. I still need to get an A because they did improve.
They moved a ton.
And their future is bright.
Yeah.
As for headline...
Car wrecked.
Yeah, it's car wrecked, yeah. That's the best way to get started. Philadelphia Eagles. Definitely better than I thought they were.
Still not a good season, though. Very, very poor. Wentz hit the wall. Receiver.
I thought they were having them do pick, to be fully honest.
Corner. Defensive help.
I would say secondary help and receiver.
Yeah.
Alright, so headline, Wentz is promising, and I'll give it a C.
I give it a C also, too.
Yep.
And that's, you know, You know, Wentz is the guy.
Yep. Pittsburgh Steelers. Defensive help.
I think. Defensive help, big time. That's probably it.
Secondary, mainly. Maybe a quarterback.
Backup running back.
Maybe. No, I think they have him. D'Angelo Williams is not that bad.
But they might move on from him.
I would say draft a quarterback. If Ben's...
Yeah, you know, what Ben's been doing recently, he's not given a full go for the season yet.
Yep.
So I think it might be time to start looking towards the future, because the future might
assholes.
Be here within the next couple of years.
Them Steeler assholes.
I give him a B.
I'll give him a B. They should have been the number two seed, at least.
Yeah. I would say burnt out is for their...
I would say cover to disaster.
Because by the end they were cooked.
Yep.
The Gooses were cooked.
San Diego Superchargers.
Disaster. Disaster, F, and everything. Los Angeles Superchargers?
Los Angeles Superchargers. I would say it's a grade, probably a F. They also the Browns.
Yeah.
They lost the
fucking Browns. The Browns beat them so bad, but like embarrassed them so bad that they had to move to Los Angeles.
Moving on up.
They shamed the city of San Diego so bad that they had to move to Los Angeles.
Moving on up.
They really need everything besides a quarterback.
Yep. All right. San Francisco 49ers.
Everything.
Except for running back.
Everything except for running back.
You know how many yards they get? I think they drafted a defensive tackle. But quarterback and defensive tackle, the top two needs. You know how many yards they gave up rushing last year? Like, on average?
Like, 200? Or
193 yards a game.
Yep.
That's usually season highs for some people.
Yep.
This is what they averaged.
Terrible. Everything... F and no longer great.
All right, I'm gonna give it an F, and I'm gonna call it Yorking it up.
Yorking it up.
Seattle Seahawks.
Seahawks. Safety.
I would say offensive line.
Offensive line, definitely. But safety, because you don't know if Earl Thomas is going to be there or not.
Yeah,
because
he has broken leg. Regulate there, Earl. Oh, shit.
Earl Thomas would have made that. Earl Thomas would have got that big. Earl Thomas would have this. Earl Thomas would have that. Earl Thomas would have saved that. Earl Thomas would have tackled him there.
Hey, that's what I usually say. Just draw a Bruins reference here. Riley Smith misses the goal. So I say he could have done that. In fact, he would actually have gotten closer than that. Maybe got a rebound off it.
I give a C because they choked in the end.
I think Gaidrey's got help. Also receiver. Wide receiver.
Receiver, yeah. What's the headline? Promising. I don't know. I can't think of anything else.
Okay, so...
I think
with
the Redskins right now.
What?
The next...
He has like 3 more. All right, so Seahawks, I'm giving it a B. Headline is... Should I put it on? Let's see here. Headline is... Dr. P. Tampa Bay. Okay, season?
Yeah.
I think Winston has the times where he needs to mature.
Yeah.
But I do see the promise with James Winston.
There is a lot of promise there.
Yep.
No really glaring needs. I think they figured them out last year, and then.
I think a nice corner. I think the secondary help is what they need.
Corner.
I think they're fine basically everywhere else except for corner. So headline probably. Bucking it up. I don't know.
Bucking it up. I've used this probably like a promising.
Promising? Tennessee Titans, 8-man improvement. This team's going to be really good next year.
The addition of DeMarco Murray.
What?
The addition of DeMarco Murray was pivotal.
Yep. They're a running first team. They're a really good offensive line.
They signed some run first guys.
Yep, I think they need some. I think they need a running back and receiver, but that's just me. Someone to take the pressure off to Marco Murray.
But it's Derrick Henry.
No, I mean like in terms of like they know that it's gonna be running the football. So like someone that gets like other than Delaney Walker gets hurt, but that's a
yeah.
Hold on, but that's what I think.
That's a good team. I mean, they're not really. There's really no glaring needs like there were last offseason.
Yep. This is a team that that I think I just didn't read that. I'll tell you later.
Okay.
This is a team that definitely was the most improved.
Yeah, definitely. If
1 year
old Mariota didn't break his fucking leg, they might have been in the playoffs.
That happened like 20 minutes apart, didn't it? Him and Derek Carr breaking the
him legs. And Derek Carr and Tyler Lockett all on the same day.
Hours apart. So I'd say probably headline. Yeah, headline is most improved.
Most improved. Yeah.
Next year they'll be in the playoffs. Redskins, don't like that.
I do not like that. That's the headline.
Don't like that.
I don't like it, and I don't like it.
Yep.
Quarterback, running back, wide receiver.
Yeah,
offensive line's not. Offensive line's fine.
Defensive line.
So you need some help on the line. And another corner to take the pressure for Breshad Breeland. Because, you know, he got toasted in one of their matchups that they had.
Yep.
Burnt toast.
Yep. So, that's actually, let's conclude. So, that's the headline. Don't like that. Don't like that. You
don't
like that.
I don't like it.
You
like
that. All right.
So, this has been the recap edition of the Football Reporter Show. We'll be back soon enough. You'll be seeing our lovely faces. Lovely faces soon enough to recap and preview and recap of free agency.
The draft.
And a preview and recap of the draft, and that would probably be it for us on that front.
Also, I will cover any trades that happen, like, as soon as they happen, initial thoughts. I also will be doing fantasy football over the summer. It's like, who should draft, who are sleepers, all that stuff. So that'll be coming in the summer. That's going to do it for me. That's going to do it for him. I can't say enjoy your football, because there's no football yet.
There's no football.
So enjoy your football withdrawal, everybody.